In today's video tutorial, we'll discuss how can we perform time series regression using the software Stata. Let's take an example. Here you can see this is the Stata software, and let's go to the data file. We have three variables: inflation, which is our dependent variable, and we have two independent variables. One is import and another one is exchange rate. So we want to see the impact of import and exchange rate on inflation. As this time series data, we have last 80 years data, which have started from 1940 and this ended 2090. So last 80 years data, so it is a time series data you can see. Right now, first you need to declare your data set to be time series. So to do this, you need to type a set. And you can see this is the time variable which we have decoded as a year, so I put it there. And since this is the yearly data, so you can write yearly, press enter. So it says it is a time series data, so you start from 1940 to 2019 and the change is 1 year. Our next job is to check whether this data, this time series data, is stationary or not. So we'll start by having a graphical analysis of the study variables. So to do this, you need to write line and your dependent variable, that is inflation, and two independent import exchange rate, and we'd like to put our time variables, that it is year, so year, comma, and then legend, and do not keep any space between legend and this first bracket, so it is it will come just after this first bracket, will come just after the legend. So legend, first bracket, and then size, and then again first bracket, made small, close up this bracket, and press enter. Now we can see the graphical presentation of these three time series data. So it denotes, which indicates this one is the inflation, import, exchange. So this actually denotes, which indicates which variable. And you can see here that these lines are actually trending upward and almost constant from 1940 to 2020. So this means during specifying our stationarity test, that is augmented decay and Fuller test that we'll use here, we have to include constant and trend. So we'll now perform augmented decay and Fuller test, and which is actually called in abbreviation ADF test. So let's see what happened to our variables at its level. So to do this, we just, you can take any of these variables, so you need to do this one by one variable. So I'm just taking one variable as an example. So you need to write the Fuller, and then for example, I'm just taking import and trend, because we need to use trend that we have seen this from this graphical presentation just before, and lag 0, so this is actually at level. Press enter. Now you can see the p-value, it is not statistically significant. That means our this variables, this data actually not stationary at level. So if it is not stationary at level, so we need to then perform the same analysis, but including lag length. So the Fuller, import, trend, lag. So I'm now including first lag. So now you can see this time it is statistically significant, right? So as it is less than 1%, so this is statistically significant. That means our data is first order integrated. So if it is not first order integrated, then you again need to run this same formula but adding more lag length here. So in this way we can check for each of these variable and say whether there are stationary at level or stationary at the first difference or at the second difference. So if our variable are first order integrated or variables are stationary in first difference, we need to perform co-integration test to establish long run relationship. Here we'll perform Johnson co-integration test, where our null hypothesis is no co-integration equation against the alternative hypothesis there is co-integration relationship. However, we need to select our determine appropriate lag length before running Johnson co-integration test. So to do this, we need to use this command where basic, it is actually two step command. So this is the first step where basic and our variable dependent variable inflation and two independent variable, and I can check this up to for example up to lag length 4, you can take lag length 5, 6, whatever, but I think it's good to check up to 5, so or 4. So 1/4, press enter, you will get some result here. And after this command, the second step, you need to type RSOC varsoc. Now you will get the selection order criteria. So these are different criteria. So this indicates what appropriate lag length you need to select. You can see here that FPE, AIC, SQIC and SBIC, these all four actually indicates, this actually star. So this all four actually indicates appropriate lag length in 2. Although LR, this criteria saying that appropriate lag length is 4, but it's the only one criteria that's saying this. But you say the maximum of these 4, they're actually indicating 2. So if you see the maximum criteria which indicates the appropriate lag length, you need to select that one. So that is actually in this case 2. So our appropriate lag length should be 2. Now we know our appropriate lag length, so we now can perform Johnson co-integration test. To do this, we need to type AC rank and then our variable, so inflation is dependent and import exchange rate and lags, and this lags that we have just identified, it is actually 2, so you need to write 2. And trend constant and level A max. So this command, you need to use this to perform this Johnson co-integration test. So you can see the result of Johnson test for co-integration. Now the decision criteria is that if your test statistic, if it is greater than your critical value, then you will reject the null hypothesis. So in that case, this, if this test statistic is greater than our maximum eigen statistics, it is greater than critical value, in that case I can say that there is a co-integration equation, a co-integration relationship exists. So I can see here that this 39 is greater than 29, so yeah, that is one co-integration relationship. However, this one actually less than 15, and this one also less than this critical value. Similarly, if you take that maximum eigen test statistic, you can see here that 28 is greater than 20, so it also indicates that at least one co-integration relationship. However, these are less than the critical value. Since both test statistics and max eigen statistics both are indicating that at least one co-integration relationship exists, so we can perform our regression, which is in our cases it is actually we call it vector auto regression model. Now, perform vector auto regression model, you need to write our formula, that is bar, that is actually vector auto regression model, and then you need to define your dependent inflation and import exchange rate. These two are independent variable, and lags, and we previously defined one by previously defined that our appropriate lag is 2, so 2 end of bracket and enter, so we get this vector auto regression result. Right, so this table is a little bit tricky, but no matter to worry, because you need to see this actually inflation, and this is the dependent variable, and this shows the relationship with this one. So our if inflation is the dependent variable, and I would like to see the relationship with the import, so there is no significant impact of import on inflation because it is not statistically significant. However, we can see here that exchange rate at the second order, you can see here it is actually statistically significant, right? So exchange rate positively actually affect our inflation at the second order, and it is statistically significant. The last stage of our analysis is the danger causality test. So to perform danger causality test, at the first step you need to type this formula, so you need to perform vector auto regression that we already have done here. So if you previously not do this, then you first need to run this command, and then you need to run this Granger causality test command. So already we have performed this, so we got this result. So just after this, you need to type the command for the Granger causality, which is very easy, just var and Granger. So you can see this is the command, and press enter. Now you can get this result here. Now import, and so this actually the causality actually runs from this one to that one, this one to that one, this one to that one. So need to see this significance value, a p-value, and you can see here import, this actually does not Granger cause inflation because it is not statistically significant. And if you consider significance level at 10%, in that case you can say yeah, exchange rate Granger cause inflation, and this all means this all together does not Granger cause inflation. However, from here you can see that inflation Granger cause import, exchange rate Granger cause import, and these two variables together Granger cause import. So in this way we can explain the result of Granger causality. Thank you.